use it a lot because they want to like invoke fear into the watchers, and they want watchers to keep watching so they can learn more information about those fake statistics. So they're just trapping them in this big, big lie, and they just keep it going with a bunch of more fake numbers.
And then if we break that down, it becomes into social media, which as in Facebook, like you have all these videos which keep on sharing and sharing and sharing, and they get more views and views, and it keeps going. So it's like they're lying to us all over
again. But like, who's the one like controlling the media? Isn't it the government telling the media to say those things?
Technically, yeah. In a way, yeah. They censor stuff.
Yeah.
Which brings us back to last year and Jacob's
censorship.
I got a question. Does anyone know how they use the word to lie?
Oh, I remember Mr. Matthews. We were kind of talking about this last year, and he showed us this picture where it was like 66%. And then it was like a pie chart, and then like the numbers like did not add up to 100, and like, but I still looked at it and I was like, oh, okay, whatever. And then I looked deeper into it and I was like, oh my god, that doesn't make sense. Like, it's because we're so used to them always being right that we don't check them for it.
So you're like saying that like they've been brainwashed and manipulated to believe and stuff?
Yeah.
So would you say that like us to the word would make it feel as if it was true, even though it doesn't? If they were just to say all Mexicans are rapists, it wouldn't feel as true as if they were to say 60% of Mexicans are rapists.
But on the other hand, I kind of disagree with you guys with Anthony Marcus.
Hey.
Because statistics can also bring out the truth in some cases.
Mm-hmm.
Like as we had the meeting with Mr. Hawkins, Mr. White, and the other day on Tuesday, I think. He brought up the saying 52 to 80, and then he asked us, we weren't able to answer, but he said that 52 is the percentage of the population that African Americans are graduating and going to college and everything. And then he asked us again, what's the 80%? And once again, we got it wrong. He told us that 80% is the number of the chances that we might end up being in jail. And we also talked about how the government's like making, when we're in third grade, they already like build a cell for us, just thinking that because we're minorities, that we're gonna wind up messing up or just bringing trouble. So my point was that it can be useful sometimes.
Disagree with you on that, because yeah, we see all these statistics and we see all these like these data points and these numbers, but isn't it like how we react to it? Like we have a choice as a person. You don't have to agree or disagree with it. Like, it's your choice, right?
I would like to agree with Caleb though that statistics are very important, because if you want to find something out about like another country or just a general population, you could use statistics to get a grasp of that if they're like the right statistics to the word. You can use it to get like a grasp on that if you took like actual statistics, the word, instead of just taking parts of it and using it to your advantage.
But how do you know which ones are the real ones?
Oh. Ooh, like the census. Do you think that the results of the census are like what's really going on, or like does the government want us thinking something else? Like,
no,
it's really weird.
The government, like, what they want us to think is what we think. What the government wants us to think is what we think. That's, we don't know everything that's going on like in this world. So what the government puts online, the media puts online, that's what we believe in. sometimes the statistics that they put out might be like only right if it benefits like the what it's going to, like what the statistics are talking about.
I want to add on to that. So like politics, for example, like if you ask somebody who is like wants for president, they're like, I don't know, I just watch TV. So like they don't really like they don't know like what they're talking about. They just see what they see on TV. Leslie said, we like, you know, we're brainwashed to what we think that everything's right.
Can I ask my question? So what I wanted to go back to was the whole being blindfolded thing.
Mm-hmm.
So my question is, do you think that maybe all those lies that they always talk about resonated from us people? Because like from the very beginning, you know, we made ourselves look kind of foolish and all, and then now they start using that to judge us now.
Can you go deeper on that?
Yeah.
They use our beliefs to make up stories, like our fears.
Can you give an example?
I think I'm trying to get what Kenny's saying, though, is like, they're using some evidence from the past to build these to build these like fears against you. Like they're using statistics from like the past when African Americans were less educated because we weren't allowing them to go to schools, and that's why they were less educated, not because they didn't want to be, it's because we weren't letting them. So it made them look worse than they actually were.
So, this is a great discussion. I'd like to let y'all know that...
No, wait.
Let it happen. I'm going to cancel the quiz.
Yes.
And...
Keep going?
Mm-hmm.
Full class.
Yeah.
This is amazing. Keep going. Everyone's allowed to talk. Oh my god.
Does it have to be
Back to Rebecca. Back to Ms. Smith. Shh.
Voices off in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna start over here. Caleb, did you have your hand raised?
We'll continue.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, when I get back to my point that I said earlier. Overall, I feel like statistics and numbers might be helping bringing the societies together, because as we were talking about the 52 over 80, we started talking about how we stick together and work as a community, that we could prove that they're wrong instead of aggravating and giving them more evidence that their statement and stereotyping is right.
I disagree with him because like some people like they have like this amount of money, like some people don't have, like they have $10, someone has $20, they think they are separating the haves and the have people who don't have things. So I disagree with him. It doesn't bring us together, it just pulls us apart because we're being separated because we're not equal.
What pulls us apart?
Like someone like people who are rich and people who are poor are separated, like because someone has more money than the other person. And for example, like people who are like black people are separated from white people because they think this race is better than the other race.
Okay, I think so.
I also disagree with Caleb. I think that the statistics kind of pull us apart, but that's because last year I was learning about this, and it was saying that minority students have a disadvantage on the tests that they take, because when they look at the statistics, it gets like it gives them discouraged that they'll do good on it, and it like messes with their mind, and it causes them to do less effective even if they're on the same level as someone who's not a minority.
As I want to add on, according to statistics, 1% of the whole entire population has the most money, because when we look at economics, it's only 1% that controls pretty much everything, while rest of the percent are hardly getting anything else.
I disagree with all of you. Because although statistics can be true or they can be lies, I feel like if we put everything in statistics, then everything could be a lie, right? So I feel like if we didn't put things in statistics and we just did things the way they are, or we based it off of how we do it ourselves, because we can't be the same as everybody else, right? That we wouldn't need statistics, because statistics wouldn't be a thing if we all did it by ourselves and we didn't place ourselves in the same group as another person.
So basically, we shouldn't be comparing ourselves to other people?
I think that's impossible, then.
Yeah, because
that's how you want to strive for greatness. Like, you want to be like, okay, I want to get a higher score than you next time.
Think of LeBron and yourself. Michael Jordan,
shoot. Statistics isn't, like, about just, like, comparing yourself to other people. Like you said, population. It could be about anything.
Can I just point out that he said that if we were not using statistics, it would be more helpful to us,
yeah?
So.
But then how would we know it
at home?
I'm sorry.
So if we didn't use statistics.
Perfect.
I'm sorry. If we didn't use that, but we can use that to benefit ourselves later. Like, if we become business owners and we become politicians, if we know how to use the word, then we can use that to benefit ourselves. And knowing how to do it, we can show others that need to know how to do it, how to do so.
Yeah, I agree with Sabian, because, like, if you, sorry, yeah. So if you, like, I agree with Sabian, because, like, if you, like, own a restaurant or whatever, and you have a competing restaurant across the street, and you look at their statistics and you look how much they're making compared to how much you're making, of course you're going to want to look at theirs and see what they're doing so that you can get better. Like, I know it's, like, selfish or whatever, but you're going to do it. Like, it's going to happen.
It's life.
It's life.
I agree with Leslie, but I disagree with Devin, because, like you said, like, if we just never use statistics, like, wouldn't that be like hiding the true reality of the world from us? Like, if statistics weren't a reality and we have them, what would there be to look for evidence?
But I feel like there's too many different variables, because, like, there could be different things that happen based off of, like, the situation you're in. So, going off of Leslie's example, you guys got two different restaurants, right? But what if y'all don't sell the same thing? So how are you guys gonna compare yourself to them, because you don't have the same thing as them? Same thing goes for rich and poor people. The poor people can't just all of a sudden become rich because they look at the rich people.
Ignore it.
I disagree with that.
Speak louder now. Talk over
honestly,
the announcement.
Honestly, like, wait, can he actually repeat that? Because I didn't hear you.
He said, like, how, like, you can't compare if you're not, like, so, like, the restaurant, if you're not selling the same thing, probably you're going to compare, like, try to go off that.
He also pointed out about comparing, comparing rich people and poor, like, if you're poor, like, you can look at rich people and be like, I want to be like them, and end up being like them. Like, you don't have to look at that. Like, it's like, you can't just be like, oh, I'm poor, I'm not going to end up having money at the end of the day. It's like, if you work hard for it, that then it's your choice, and it's up to you.
It gives you confidence.
Yeah.
Okay. I want to...
No, yeah, no.
One more.
Okay.
Yeah,
more.
Any comment?
We'll do this on Monday.
No, we have 2 minutes.
I agree
with Devin. Hold on, she's talking. Don't rustle up your papers. Make more noise.
I agree with Devin, because, like, you have to hear the two things that are totally different.
Awesome.
So
what we need from you now, we need your homework.
Wait, sit down. Don't pack up.
We need your homework, your discussion sheet, your answers to the questions we gave you, and your text. Put it all in one nice pile on your desk.